If you could live anywhere in the world, where would it be? You voted and your top five picks are rolling out this week. Your number four choice is the island of Bali. Adrian is looking for an escape from his hectic life in Tokyo.
I need a place kind of where I can go and just, you know, literally turn my brain off for a while.
And what better place for a vacation home than the tropical island of Bali?
So this is what the whole outdoor bathroom is all about. It's quite literally just outdoors, yeah? Wow, it's really big, actually. Wouldn't mind waking up to that every morning. I could get used to that.
Welcome to Fantasy Location Countdown Week.
My father's Japanese, my mother's from Northern Ireland. I went to university in the US. I moved back to Tokyo 6 years ago, right after I graduated from university. I'm an equity index option broker for an English financial company. I have a very demanding job, usually requires 12, 13 hours a day. And that's why I need a place kind of where I can go and just, you know, literally turn my brain off for a while. And there isn't really a place you can do that in Tokyo. I've done a lot of traveling in my life. I've been to all sorts of places, but I like going to warm places where I can relax in the sun. First time I went to Bali, I stayed in kind of like a beach resort and fell in love with the place. You know, there's a direct flight. It's only 6.5, 7 hours to get there. They have beautiful beaches. They have nice restaurants. They have really unique, cool like clubs. I mean, there's just so many things to do. The fact that there was something that nice, that was that close to Tokyo and that convenient, I already started putting the thought in that maybe, you know, one day I could get a place here. The apartment is 2-bedroom, 2-bathroom, 145 square meters, which is quite big for 2-bedroom and 2-bathroom. As you can see here, like the windows compared to most apartments in Tokyo, it's like wall-to-wall windows, so it gets a lot of sunlight. When I head over to Bali and look at some of the places there, that's going to be one of the things I'm looking for. Preferably, you know, there'd be a swimming pool there instead of a street. I really like this kitchen, though I don't really use it so much. Cooking is something I'd like to get into one day, but that day hasn't exactly arrived for me. Most of the villas in Bali have an in-house butler service where they'll come in at night and make you some dinner. But, you know, when you're there, usually you want to be out and about and checking out the restaurants and trying all the different places to eat there. So this is my bedroom. I like it in here, very spacious. This is my office. I don't really use it for that much. I'll be using it a lot less in Bali because I don't want to do any work there. It's strictly for vacation. In Bali, I'm looking for at least 2 bedrooms. I'll be doing a lot of entertaining and I want friends to come visit me. So that's gonna be very important. All right, you need to eat. So she just kind of hangs out here in my bathtub when I go to the office or whatever. It's a nice sized bathroom for Tokyo standards. When I head to Bali, I'm looking for a 2-bathroom for sure, just for guests and whatnot. Wow, that's awesome. My budget is up to 45 million yen. Ideally, I'd like to get something for a little bit less than that. When I'm not there, I plan to rent it out. That's one feature I definitely would like to get out of it. I'm really excited about this. This is the first piece of property I'll be buying, and it's just nice to know that it'll be in a place like Bali. So yeah, I'm definitely very, very excited about it.
Houses in Bali are called villas, and we have different types of villas in a complex, or there could be a standalone villa. The villa complex is more or less like a condo would be in America. The currency here is Indonesian rupiah, but most of the villas for sale here are priced in US dollars. I think one of our biggest challenges is going to be for him to make a decision because there are so many beautiful villas here. It's probably going to be a little bit hard for him to choose. I might even end up selling him too.
I made it, finally.
Welcome back to Bali.
Thank you. Very happy to be here. Really excited about this. So how far is it, a walk from here, from the beach?
It's only a 5-minute walk.
Okay.
These are the 9 villas here. Uh-huh. It's already set up with its own management company.
Okay.
It actually runs like a boutique hotel.
Okay.
So I think that that's something interesting for you because it's basically a turnkey right. type of situation. This villa I'm showing you today uh-huh. is 2-bedroom, 2-bath.
Okay.
It's 237 square meters.
Okay.
And the asking price is $330,000.
Okay, nice.
Ta-da!
Some really high-class stuff, huh?
Very nice.
Yeah. So this would all be mine?
It would all be yours. The bedroom's over here and the living space is over here, completely separate on this side. Okay. So everything you see in the villa comes with the villa.
Okay.
It's turnkey.
Very nice.
We even have your glasses, toaster, everything you need is included, everything you're seeing today.
Okay. Well, this works for me. It's really, you know, it looks cool, it looks modern. I won't be using it that much, but
yeah,
you know, that's the most important thing.
And if you don't want to cook, you could always order in.
Okay.
Or you could ask the staff to cook you something. That's included in the amenities.
All right, understood.
Dining area.
Oh, nice. Nice table. I like the kind of oak look that the place has, you know, like the high ceilings. It's all kind of the same color. Oh, it's really cool. I like it.
It's a traditional Balinese architecture.
Okay, nice. You can actually fit a lot of people in here, which is, it's good to know, right?
Yeah.
Big L-shaped sofa, opening up the windows, having a couple beers, relaxing.
Yeah, indoor-outdoor option. Most of the villas in Bali have that indoor-outdoor option because that's the whole point. But this is also can be closed off and air-conditioned.
Okay.
If it gets too hot or something like that.
Well, this is exactly what I was looking for. I really like this. Well, I still can't get over this pool. This is great.
Yeah, definitely nice and refreshing.
Yeah.
So the two bedrooms here are actually identical twins.
Uh-huh.
We don't have a master bedroom here.
Okay. Well, that doesn't really bother me.
Okay. Let me show you this one first.
Uh-huh. Nice. It's a king-size bed, which is great. I've never had a canopy before, so that's kind of cool. What's this? Just like a design or?
Well, that's actually a very fancy mosquito net if you pull it.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. It goes all the way around.
Right. Because okay. It's an indoor-outdoor option. If you want to sleep with the doors open,
right,
you're protected from the mosquitoes.
Better off closing that up, yeah. It's a nice room, high ceilings. I like how they kept the pattern consistent with the living room.
Yeah, wood floors.
Yeah, with the dark oak. Oh, wow.
Indoor-outdoor garden bathroom.
So this is what the whole outdoor bathroom is all about. It's quite literally just outdoors, yeah?
It's like you're out in nature.
Right. Now you definitely don't have this in Tokyo. That's for sure. I like the tub. Nice tub. Cool sink. Stone sink. So it's like those tropical kind of raining effect.
Rain shower.
Right? Yeah, that's really nice.
They check out the guest suite last.
I really like the place.
Oh, good. I'm really glad you like it.
Yeah, I mean, just from the moment you walk in, you know, doors open and, you know, it's just got a very kind of simple setup, which is what I like. I guess I could have done with a little bit more garden, but it's not really a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the pool's awesome. I'll be using that a lot. I guess the fact that there's no bathroom in this side of the villa, at the end of the day, it's not a big deal for me.
Every villa has compromises. You know, you also have to consider it's very close to all your favorite spots.
Uh-huh.
5-minute walk to the beach.
Right.
And you can very easily rent this out when you're not here.
Yep. Now those are all big plus points for me.
So this house is a little bit different than the one that I showed you yesterday.
Okay. This is the selling point of the villa, yeah?
Definitely. Yeah.
And later...
Yes, and you have like Buddha right there. You can have like a Zen bathing experience.
Adrian is looking for a vacation home in Bali where he can finally unwind from his hectic Tokyo lifestyle. So far he's seen a villa with a split floor plan and a small private pool. But there's no guest bath in the main living space.
So this house is a little bit different than the one that I showed you yesterday.
Okay.
And it's in a neighborhood that isn't as developed as the other areas that I'm showing you.
Okay. I like that we have like lots of, it's like a proper driveway, you know, you could put a couple cars even. If you have people coming to visit, there's a lot of space here for
it. And there's also a covered garage here.
Okay. I really love the garden here. It's like, you know, it's so private.
It's a two-story house. It's a 3-bedroom, 2-bath.
Okay. Wow, it's really big here, right? It's a proper house. How much is this one going for?
This is US dollars, $375,000.
Okay.
A little bit more than yesterday's villa.
But it's not that much extra considering the size of the place.
Check this out. This is also open plan.
Okay. Wow, it's really big, actually.
I do know that you'd mentioned that you want a more modern style furniture and furnishings, but The furniture in this one isn't included.
Not really my thing, furniture-wise. Oh, wow. This is the
Amazing.
Selling point of the villa, yeah?
Definitely.
Yeah.
This is really what makes the property.
No, definitely, this is great. You got the little garden here, the pool's right there. It's nice, you could put a ton of people out here, yeah?
This is a 10-year-old garden, so you've got a lot of great tropical garden here.
Gotcha.
So let me show you the dining area and the kitchen.
Okay.
Simple dining.
Right. Oh, it's nice how, well, there's windows on both sides, so like a nice draft comes through. It's a really nice breeze.
Indoor, outdoor option.
Yeah.
Small kitchen.
That's not really a big deal for me. I mean, oven, sink, perfect. I'll probably never even use the oven, so.
The master suite's pretty cool.
Okay.
It's got its own sitting room, so it's kind of like your own private area.
Okay. No, it's definitely nice that, you know, it's separated and it's like your own private quarters. Oh, nice bed. No, it's really big. I like that, the feel that it has.
Veranda.
Oh, that's cool. So you can just go straight out to the garden from here.
Right, exactly.
That's very nice.
You can really see how big the garden is from here.
Yeah, I definitely like that. It's great.
Indoor, outdoor, tropical garden bathroom.
Cool. I really like this place. Nice. That's a great outdoor shower too.
And stone sink.
Okay.
It's all traditional.
Nice and durable.
So let's go ahead and check out the other guest rooms upstairs.
Lead the way. Now this loft thing definitely works for me. I like how you can just kind of lean over and just whatever. If there's people hanging out down there, you can talk to them from up here or whatever. This is a plus.
The guest bedroom, open air, and it's air conditioned as well.
Cool. Nice view.
Connecting bathroom to the other guest room.
All right.
They also take a quick peek at the other bedroom.
Yeah, I mean, I really like the place. Not only is it very big, I think the space is used very well in it. Everything's all open. You have the view of the pool, like no matter where you're kind of standing, which is important for me. I just think it's got a really nice traditional feel to it. The one intimidating thing about it would be the size. It is very big. That's would be my only hesitation.
You could hire an outside management company to take care of it for you.
Okay.
While you're away, you know, rent it out.
Okay.
Get some return on your investment.
Yeah, this could be me. It's exciting, you know, it's an actual house.
Okay,
so
good.
Pretty, kind of a cool thought to maybe know that I could own a house, you know?
This villa is at the top of your price range, but I really wanted you to consider it.
Sweet. That was unexpected, actually. You can see kind of like where the extra dollar goes in this place.
Adrian's hoping to purchase his first place in Bali. He's been looking for a vacation home there where he can take a break from his fast-paced Tokyo lifestyle. His first option is close to the beach and comes fully furnished, but there's no bathroom in the main living area. The second place is a standalone house with tons of outdoor space, but it's in a more rural area and it doesn't come with a management company.
This villa is also in the area that would appeal to you because of all the restaurants we just saw that we drove by and the nightlife.
Okay.
I know this villa is at the top of your price range, but I really wanted you to consider it because I think there's a lot of things interesting about it. You got your one area for parking.
This is for parking?
Yes, this is your parking space
in
the typical bamboo as you walk in. A home for your turtle.
Awesome.
A fish pond.
Wow.
Watch your step.
I guess I gotta be careful when I come home at night.
Exactly.
I could fall in. Wow, this is beautiful.
This is a two-bedroom, two-bath house.
Okay.
220 square meters.
Okay. It's really nice landscaping. Exactly how much is this place going for?
$475,000.
Wow.
So let's start in the master bedroom.
Okay. Oh, cool. It's all marbled as well.
Yeah. Oh, yes. There's a marble throughout the whole villa.
Huh?
King-size bed.
Okay. So does the price include all the furniture?
Yes, the price includes all the furniture. Some of the artwork's not included.
Okay.
But you'll notice here, this is handcrafted by a local Balinese designer, coconut wood.
I noticed that all the villas, they use coconut wood. Is there a reason for that?
Well, most of the villas have chosen their materials for their durability to the climate.
Oh, okay. Wouldn't mind waking up to that every morning. There's the pool, you got the trees coming over. I could get used to that.
So you'll see that the bathroom is quite large.
Oh, cool. I'm liking the double sink. It's
yes, nice. Double sink basin.
That's an awesome tub. Huge. Yes, and you have like Buddha right there. You can have like a Zen bathing experience.
Exactly. And one of the best features about this bathroom is that it's air conditioned. You okay. can have the choice of indoor shower or outdoor shower. Okay. That really helps a lot, especially when it's hot in Bali and you want to go out and you're trying to get ready and you're sweating.
Right.
So you can have the choice. So the guest bedroom and ensuite bathroom is this way.
Okay.
Also king-size nice. Bed.
It's not as cool as the master bedroom, but it works.
So you've got a large wardrobe. You've got a desk with Wi-Fi hookup here.
Uh-huh.
Here is the bathroom
uh-huh.
that also shares with the rest of the house
okay.
for your guest bathroom.
Cool. There's no Buddha in here, though.
No Buddha in here.
Okay. It still works. It's nice, like the sink area. Kind of looks like a floating sink and mirror, which is nice.
The main living area is open plan.
Cool. That's actually the best kitchen we've seen so far. I like the black here and the beige. It's a really cool contrast. Looks really modern. I like that.
It's a great management company here.
Okay.
They'll cook for you. You have a private chef.
Cool. That works for me perfectly. Yeah. I really like this whole open concept here. Like, it's not just one or two open windows. I mean, the whole wall is just a giant kind of window, right? I like the really high ceilings. You don't feel like you're constricted at all. It's just completely open, which is great.
Yeah. Yeah. Is this really your kind of furniture? Because remember, all the furniture is included in the price. I mean, is this really your style?
I mean, I wouldn't be replacing it, but it's not exactly this isn't exactly my style, but I don't really care about that sort of thing. The fact that there's a pool right there I could just jump straight into.
Great party house.
That's my style, yeah.
I saved this part for you for last.
Okay.
Because I think it's one of the major pluses of this place. It's what I would consider to be the second living area.
All right. Hi. Oh, sweet. That was unexpected, actually. That's awesome. You can see kind of like where the extra dollar goes in this place, for sure. This is a big plus to have something like this.
So, Adrian, do you like it?
Yeah, I really like it. I like how from basically the moment you walk in, the place flows very well, and it's very well kind of designed. The master bedroom, you know, it's separated from the rest. You just want like your private time. The one thing I kind of don't like is just the design of the furniture. But other than that, I mean, yeah, it's great. And then, you know, at the very end when you showed me the roof terrace, like, you know, for me that's kind of the nail in the coffin in terms of things I really like about it here. So
I think it's a great party place. I think it's, you know, close to everything you like. It could be managed by somebody else.
Exactly.
When you're not here, so the upkeep is taken care of for you.
Yep.
I think it's a good possibility for you.
I really liked it. So where do I sign?
Did Adrian choose the least expensive place with a split floor plan? The standalone villa with a large garden? Or the priciest place with a rooftop terrace?
I can't believe this is finally happening.
Yeah, welcome to the
really
Bali
excited.
Family.
Thanks a lot. Thanks
good
for all your help.
Adrian has toured three unique vacation homes in Bali, and he's finally ready to make one of them his home away from home. His first option is the least expensive. Priced at $330,000, it has two bedrooms and two baths in 2,500 square feet.
The Seri Villas I really liked because of the flow. Just from the moment I walked into it, it had a really nice feel to it. Just the way that the bedrooms were on one side and the living, dining, kitchen was on the other. The pool's great, right in the middle. It was a bit strange how there's no bathroom on the living, dining, kitchen side. It was the smallest of the three, but I liked how it had a management company there for me for the rentals.
Listed for $375,000, this villa is the largest with three bedrooms and two baths in 2,600 square feet.
The size was a little bit intimidating for a vacation villa, but I loved the outdoor garden and the terrace area. The idea of a three bedroom is kind of nice, but that does also come along with a lot of upkeep. I like the overall feel, the whole in and out feel, but I didn't like how there's no management company associated with it.
His third option is the most expensive, priced at $475,000. It has two bedrooms and two bathrooms and 2,400 square feet.
The villa at the residence was very beautiful. However, I didn't really like the interior design. The flow and the landscaping was definitely fantastic, but it was at the top of my budget. The roof terrace was awesome. That was my favorite part. The location was good, but it wasn't the best of the three.
So, which one did he choose?
The villa I finally decided to go with was the Seri Villas. The place is just absolutely me. The asking price was 330,000, which is around 33 million yen. I ended up getting it for 320,000, so I'm very happy about that. Nice. This is my second time back to Bali since I bought the villa 4 months ago. Now I'm a homeowner, and it's a very different feeling when you walk around. It's like, wow, this place is actually mine. And that's a really cool feeling. Since I bought the place, I've, you know, kind of made it feel a bit more like home. I've taken the boutique kind of look away. You know, just added a few things. You know, when I go out shopping, I pick up a couple ornaments or whatever and just put it around the villa, just so it has a more feeling of it, like it's my home. Yeah, so this is kind of my routine in the morning. You know, jump in the pool, grab a cup of coffee. Yeah, the kitchen really isn't a big deal for me. I'm so close to Restaurant Row, which is where I normally eat. If I do want to order in, like, you know, what I do for breakfast, I can just pick up the phone here, hit zero, and I can have, you know, anything here from scrambled eggs to sushi and, like, delivered in, like, 30 minutes. Having two bedrooms is kind of nice. I only use this one right here. I've changed a couple of things to make it a little bit more like home. I plan on coming here several times a year. While I'm not here, you know, I'll be renting it out, and that's why, you know, the management company is great, because I don't have to worry about the day-to-day stuff. It's just all done for me. I just say, listen, I'm renting it out from this time to this time. So that's pretty cool. So look at where I am, right in the middle of paradise. This is the exact opposite from Tokyo. No crowds, no traffic, nothing. There's just nobody here. It's beautiful. I think I just made the best decision buying here. This is awesome.
Don't forget to tune in tomorrow as the countdown continues. Which fantasy location was chosen as number 3?